follow us at MR Shannon. I can't do it. MR Shannon Films.
All right, so finally getting to go on the Eastern European road trip. I've been talking about it for years, but finally gonna hit up Prague, Budapest, Vienna, Venice. I've really been looking forward to this trip. And as you can see, I'm doing the first leg of it by myself because I'm meeting Emily and Ricky down in Venice, which means I gotta drive 10 hours straight down to Venice. First stop on the trip is Venice, and as you can see, it is absolutely beautiful. So happy I was finally able to make it to this city, but it's just the first stop. The thing that makes Venice so special is right behind me. You have the canal, and you have the boats that everyone talks about. It's pretty cool. Swore I was through, but looking at you, I think I changed my mind. Yeah, it's falling in love for the fun of it. Diving at first in all of it. Oh, what a rush, looking into your eyes, playing it off like it's different this time. Let's break it.
Slovenia. What do I know about it?
It exists.
There's a language. It's called Slovenian. I learned that today.
Okay, that's a good start.
That's literally all I know. There's a castle over there. There's some mountains over there.
That's not a castle. It's like a church.
Cloud. No, that was definitely built in like 1203.
Did you compliment a cloud that is not actually part of the country of Slovenia?
It's above the country.
Well,
like
so?
That's disrespectful, to be honest. It's hovering right above it.
I don't know.
That's just me, maybe. I have a level of respect.
He has nothing for nobody.
I do. Yo, get the speaker box loud. Hitting that stuff till you hearing that sound.
We're driving to the capital of Slovenia, which is LL Cool J.
But seriously, it's like
how the hell do you pronounce it?
Lavagugia.
That sounds way too Italian. It's more of like a Slavic language.
How do you pronounce the capital of Slovenia?
Slovenia. Or maybe it's Slovenia.
I can't get the answer to that on iPhone.
That's not a response that I wanted. All right, yeah, this, we'll have to pause this until we can get an actual answer.
All right, no,
next
time.
I got it.
Or not, okay.
No, I'm really
hurting these transitions. It's going to be a lot more effort for me to edit out.
Capital of Slovenia, verbally.
Out of this entire 3-minute bite, I may be able to salvage like 5 seconds. So thanks for that.
I got it. Okay, come on. Yeah.
You're killing my battery.
I know. Ljubljana.
Ljub.
Ljub.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ljubljana.
I have like
LL. That's so
Ljubljana.
Much easier.
Yeah, but LL Cool J is just
all
so
right,
much
I
better.
I like LL Cool J. All right, we're driving to LL Cool J.
The verdict is decided.
Yep.
The first So we finally made it to Lake Bled.
Okay.
I can't say that in the YouTube video.
We finally made it to Lake Bled. Fans.
Oh my gosh.
Feet pics? How much?
We finally made it to Lake Bled. The number one thing to do in all of Slovenia, apparently, according to Google.
Slovenia.
Slovenia. I think it's Slovenia.
Slovenia? Slovenia.
We'll figure it out in the edits, but...
Hey, Slovenia.
Hi. They're not funny.
We're so
but as you can see, the view is absolutely amazing. And I think it's definitely worth the trip, at least according to Google Top 10.
Yeah, I just hurt my knees.
Okay, just made it to our second glamping in Slovenia, or Slovenia, whatever. So it looks pretty awesome.
You know what? These are always dramatic. You know what I mean?
Are we embarrassed?
No! Stop! Mike!
He does cross it. Slovenia has been an absolute surprise. Saw a lot of pictures on Instagram and videos on YouTube. I'm like, yeah, I think I want to check that place out. And I'm so happy I did, because this country, what it has to offer, it's unbelievable. All right, next adventure, biking to dinner.
It's like Nicaragua all over again.
Honestly, I'm getting Nicaragua vibes right now.
Oh God, see something, say something vibes.
Oh, that's a funny story. We were in Greece and there was a bag that was left on the train and we thought we were gonna die from a bomb attack. So the thing was, we said something or we saw something, but we didn't say anything.
Nothing, we got off the train.
So I think we're the problem. Granted, we would have been the casualties, but...
I'm the problem.
So the thing about Ricky is that he's just mooching this entire trip. He's planned absolutely nothing and he's just literally along for the ride.
I wrote a Word document for 2 hours.
Yeah, he went to Google the top 10 things to do and copy and paste it. So he worked 2 hours.
But how else do you want me to, what do you want me to do?
He's
where would
this
you
trip.
Have gone for tips? The pause.
Pause.
No.
Oh, you want me to keep it rolling?
Well, I'm asking, where would you have gone for tips?
That's why I had you do it.
But
so,
you would have gotten to the Google.
Yeah, but I wouldn't have just generically Googled top 10s to do in like Hungary.
I sifted through lists and I
would have looked at the route. I would have
curated
like,
numbers from different places. I don't want to hear it.
Yeah,
I'm leaving.
Neither
Bye.
Does the audience.
Uh-uh.
Nope.
Okay.
We're about to head out from Slovenia. It has been an awesome time and I'm excited. So we're going down to Budapest.
M70, are you filming me? Really? Okay, so M70, you would get off, see? Like the road goes like that and
can't swear.
I mean, oh.
So we're deciding right now if it's worth going to the intersection of Slovenia, Hungary, and Croatia. It's gonna be very anticlimactic no matter what, but we're gonna do it because...
Like, just to say we did it, I guess, like...
Is that something worth saying you did?
I don't know. How often in life do you get to experience a tri country moment?
I feel like it's very common in Europe. Like, if you want it, it's there.
We're not all Europeans.
Well, none of us are Europeans.
I know.
There's someone would actually I need to get off of.
Yeah, I will.
Thank you for finally contributing, though.
I have neck problems right now. I don't want to hear it.
So this is what the backwoods of Hungary look like. Interesting. Okay, so check this out. Ricky took us on a wild goose chase to go see the three corners of like three countries or whatever. This is what it looks like. Dirt road, dirt road, dirt road.
I'm gonna get out and take a picture.
Which country trail do you want to go walk to? Cause like, I don't know.
So I directed us to a spot where it meets Croatia, Hungary, and Slovenia. And it took me here. Mike, don't go.
Alright, so Ricky's 0-2 in Hungary. That's okay. Bounce back.
I'm hungry and hungry. No one's ever made that joke before.
We're gonna have the out of that.
Why? It was a good joke.
Okay, say it again.
I'm hungry and hungry. What do you want?
The poop is inside right now, giving a service. Pretty cool. My friend Steve.
We're driving cars on a Mars tonight. We're blasting up to the stars tonight. We wanna go, go. We wanna go, go.
At MR Shannon Films. It's
guys, someone go like this video so we don't have to live in New Brunswick.
We have. I got a job offer to New Brunswick, New Jersey. Not a fan.
This is not.
Welcome to Bratislava. What is up, Bratislava?
What is Bratislava? I know what Bratislava is.
Bratislava!
It's giving USSR, let me tell you.
It's giving USSR.
Oh, look at that really cute street though. We can walk up it in the rain.
That's a cute street. Oh, with the little thing. Yeah, I like that. Let's go up there.
Welcome to Bratislava.
Bratislava.
Welcome to Bratislava.
Mike, I'm not kidding. It kind of makes you seem like
the little. What was the
Deloitte.
No, it's the little.
Deloitte.
Maybe we can
married at the mall.
Bratislava. USSR. Jesus.
Alright, I gotta figure out.
Alice.
Oh,
I was like. And Alice is on the ride now. It's
turning
up.
For a minute in the quiet, it feels like it was before. I get lost just for a moment, thinking I'm not where I am. And I didn't want to feel this way, tired of being out of place. Give me a one-way ticket out of here someplace. I know I can't be happy, it's not
I can sit and cry about reasons why I'm in this mess. But what good is that? What
all right, too long. What are you gonna tell him? What are you gonna tell him? Go ahead.
To do a little bit of a recap, we've kind of been YOLOing this trip by driving to a city and booking a hotel about an hour, 2 hours before we actually get to the city.
We gotta have totally fine. This morning.
It's been working.
You know? Did that at 9 a.m.
As you can hear from the peanut gallery, it has been working.
And today?
But today, every single hotel in Vienna, Bratislava, all these other places that I can't pronounce. Bratislava.
Oh, there's gelato.
Everything's booked, and we can't get anything less for $800 a night. And so, we're hurting right now. Morale is dangerously low. Everyone wants to kill each other. They've just abandoned me. But we're trying not to sleep in the car tonight, and that's where we're at.
How are you doing right now, boy? Greg, give us a story.
I think, I don't know, I kind of lost it. I'm just going to be honest. What a waste of breath. It's a fine line thinking about the words on set. And
setting me free from my chest. I feel so alone. So we're in Vienna just for the day. Honestly, for about 6 hours max. And we're going to try and see as much of the city as we can. And as you can see, Ricky tried to jump in the shot because he is a whore for the camera.
I'm not. I just want to be a part of something. Damn.
So far, Vienna, 10 out of 10. We've been to a lot of European cities, and this one has not disappointed, especially like the last one. But I'm excited. Next, we have Prague, and from everyone I've ever talked to, they've always said Prague is the best European city to visit. And so, hey, let's go check it out. Welcome to Prague.
I've been on the road. I've been doing shows, now we eating steak, remember sleeping on the floor. Stealing at the gas station when the time's cold. In the kitchen, hot still trying to flip it off the stove. Rocking fake J's, praying that nobody know. Watch him take my dog away, it was way too hard to stay composed. Fight to see the light of day, all the blood on my clothes. I was tired every day, green light, it's time to go. I don't wanna live life fast or die too young. Die too young. 100 miles per hour, I might crash, cause a good die young. Yeah, a good die young. Pushing to the limit, I can't go no more. Red light, no way, I'm coming back home. Long dirt road, all on my own. I'ma be the greatest, write my name in the stone. Write my name in the stone. Yeah, I'm coming back home. Yeah, I'm coming back home. Write my name in the stone. Cause I'm coming back home. Where I left because I know my people needed me. Diamond in the rough, I don't know what it is they see in me. Go down as a legend in my city because we beat the streets. Trying to spread the wealth around the block, no, I can't keep from me. Told me I should leave. I see the bigger picture and it's way bigger than me. Can't be living like a king, but my people need to eat. If I got it, then you got it. We gonna get back on our feet.
How is
and
it?
I put that on me. I don't wanna live life fast or die too young. Or die too young. 100 miles per hour might crash because good die young. But here I come. Push it to the limit, I can't go no more. Red light, no way, I'm coming back home. Long dirt road, all on my own. I'ma be the greatest, write my name in the stone. Write my name in the stone. Yeah, I'm coming back home. Yeah,
we are exploring Prague. It is definitely one of the most amazing cities in Europe. 100% top five.
It's a lot of tour groups.
A lot of tour groups, so that does suck. We're gonna have to sit down and figure out where it ranks in the top five, but the history, the architecture, the oldness to the city, the food's pretty great.
Food's pretty good.
Beer's awesome.
Big meat guy.
So, I really gotta say, Prague is an absolutely amazing city.
Absolutely agree.
All right, finally going to do the most famous thing to do in Prague, and that is a beer bath, so let's check it out. All right, let's get in this beer bath. Make sure you add beer bath to the list of things to do in Prague.
Oh, I poured it perfectly.
Shannon Films, follow for more.
Here we are. Mike's been ragging on me about like providing quality content, but I still don't have quality content to provide. So that's all I got to say. Have a great day. Bye.
So I'm gonna be honest with you right now, this is some of the best boba I've ever had in my life. Who would have guessed I would have found it in Vienna? Awesome city, by the way.
Looks like he just ran a 5K.
All right, click it.